obviously, it's been about a month and a half since our last cabinet meeting, and I'm really, really pleased about how, as an administration, we've continued to hit the ground running. You know, we have pledged the people of the city hard work, not fireworks, and I'm really pleased to say that certainly has been the story of the past 6 weeks or so. Lots of hard work from everyone around this table, and exactly as it should be. I think for me, though, it boils down to kind of two key aspects, absolutely. One being delivery, the other being teamwork. And I'm really, really pleased about the delivery we've already begun in the short term since the local elections. I'm obviously not going to steal Laura's thunder about the report we have going to have shortly about the neighbourhood model, but that is absolutely key to how we go forward as City Council and deliver the best possible services we can for all of our communities across the city. Very much linked to all of that is the great work Laura's been doing, particularly with LSSL, about how we improve street cleaning across the city. I think we all know that there are parts of the city where that has to improve, and that doesn't mean the kind of the austerity we've faced over the past 13 years makes that easy. It certainly doesn't, but we can continue to be smarter to look at how we deliver a better outcome for so many of our residents. Again, I've spent quite a bit of time with Laura and also some of the councillors like John Morris and Jane Roberts and the work they've been doing around Smithdown Ward and those areas where kind of many students live in the city, not least because of the real problems that a number of bad landlords and the behaviour of some students, not all by a long stretch, caused a few weeks ago. I want to put on record my thanks to the team for getting things cleaned as quickly as they did, but at a strategic level, we've already been working with the university to look at the ways in which we can continue to deal with that as smart as possible for future academic years. Again, on the theme of delivery, I'm really excited that tomorrow I'm visiting the first family hub in the city. You know, I'm really pleased how, under Labour administrations continually for the past 13 years, not only have we protected children's centres across the city, something we should be rightfully proud of, that many other comparable councils haven't been able to do, but we always pledged in this document, our manifesto, that we would actually go further and take our children's centres and develop them up into family hubs. So the fact that the first one will be launched tomorrow at Clubmore Children's Centre to develop that into a family hub is really good delivery within weeks since the election. Again, we should never lose the opportunity to mention not just how successful Eurovision was for the city, but how we continue to build on the legacy of kind of the visitor economy and particularly the Eurovision Song Contest in the city. You know, kind of last week, Harry, you were hosting the Modern Music Cities Conference, another example of how we're leading on the music industry and music tourism. And I think we're all looking forward to hosting Pride on behalf of Eve in just over a week's time, because that again strengthens our deep links that we have with Ukraine. Again, I know kind of most school children in the city are breaking up for summer tomorrow, so it's great that the council continues to deliver a really good fall programme of youth activities for so many of our youngsters right across the city for the next 6 weeks. And again, in the education field, we've had some more great delivery with the work that Miller picked up from Tom Logan as the previous cabinet member in launching the school anti-racism network, really kind of focusing on best practice of how we work with schools across the city and actually a number of leading institutions nationally to make sure we're always tackling any forms of discrimination and making sure that those things never take root with young people. I think the other element of delivery that was great to be witness to today, obviously, was the unveiling of the Nelson Mandela Memorial. It was absolutely wonderful that the city again has been able to welcome the Mandela family to unveil the great work that the council supported the LA charity Mandela Aid to deliver that really good positive legacy for what I believe was one of the greatest individuals, not just of the 20th century, but actually of human history in terms of what Nelson Mandela achieved. How this city had a proud record of being a strong anti-apartheid city, has strong links with South Africa and the Mandela family. It's lovely to see that memorial beginning to unveil today, that I really sort of hope and know will be a strong inspiration for many young people across the city for many years to come about the real positive life and legacy of Nelson Mandela. So a lot that we've delivered on in the past few weeks, but all that for me boils down to a lot of teamwork. Great teamwork across the cabinet, great teamwork across our group as a ruling administration, great teamwork with Steve Rotherham and the combined authority. He's asked me to continue in the role of leading on transport, very much focusing on bus franchising so we can make sure that passengers are the most important people on the bus network, not shareholder dividends, as has been the priority previously. How we've been working really closely with Steve and the Command Authorities team on Strategic Futures Panel, with Hal Bernstein and Judith Blake. You know, it's great that we're right at the heart of that kind of exciting piece of work. Again, a lot of work that we're starting to look at how we can go much further on devolution for the city and the region, particularly with the Labour government, that would give us the opportunities to seek further devolved opportunities. But equally as well, our collective lobbying as a city with the city region to make the very strong case for Liverpool to be the home of the English National Opera. Again, it goes back to that strong link with our musical heritage and our real sort of strong core of music being in our DNA. We know that we'd be able to kind of be a wonderful home for the English National Opera. Again, some great team working with the commissioners as well. We've got the new oversight board in place, and it's great how we've been pulling together some of those detailed markers and some of the things that we've got to be working through collectively to make sure that we can conclude the council's improvement journey that allows us to conclude the formal intervention, but crucially making sure that we continue that strong trajectory, as is all of our vision, to become an exemplar local authority for the people of the city. I think the final point, though, is that that's what it's all about, actually. It's about delivering for the people of the city. And one of the things that I've been really, really keen to do is get out and about around the city. So I really kind of thank those ward councillors that have invited me and hosted me out in their wards to see so many different things. I will make sure I continue doing that. But equally as well, we've had a number of offers to hold cabinet meetings actually out of the town hall in other parts of the city as well. And I'm very conscious we're joined by members of the press, for example. So we'd be really keen to see if there's any thoughts and ideas from your readers and your kind of listeners and viewers, that if there are different places around the city you would like us to take a cabinet meeting, or organisations where we possibly could host a cabinet meeting, we'd be really keen to get out and do that. So, as you can tell, quite a few things have happened over the past 6 weeks, but I think it's really important to keep checking in with this opportunity of making those announcements. So, with all of that, should we move on if everyone's agreeable with that? The fourth item, obviously, is any matters referred by scrutiny committees. Obviously, we've only just started the first cycle of the scrutiny committee, so at this stage, nothing has been submitted to us, but obviously we look forward
massive goal that we have that we're trying to sort of achieve here in terms of improving those services, and a very challenging one, again, that Chair's already mentioned about austerity. We're all aware of the amount of impact that austerity got cuts on government funding to local authorities has had on all the services we provide, but we cannot ignore how disproportionate that's been on neighbouring services, on those services that basically everyone uses. So the ultimate sort of irony is that those services that everyone sees, that everyone needs, that everyone accesses, highways, potholes in roads, green spaces, waste recycling, waste reduction, all those issues have been hit out of proportion even to the enormous cuts that local authorities have endured. Not just Liverpool, all local authorities, but here in Liverpool we have lost about half the money, half the funding to our local, into our actual neighbouring service for about £55 million we've cut from those in the last 12 years or so. So it's a massive challenge. And the neighbourhood model is starting to try and answer some of that in terms of actually improving those services, in terms of delivering things in a different way. Okay, so it's about, whilst we are not in any way accepting of those costs, it's about how we absolutely use the resources and the capacity that we do have in the best possible way, and about being more efficient, more effective, and smarter in how we do things, and having those services really close to the people that they serve, so that we can try and do the best we can with the resources that we have got. So there are award-winning underground bins, by the way, which did win an award at the Liverpool Chronicle quite recently, so well done to the team and the board for that. So how are we, got too good at it now, how are we actually going to achieve these things? So one of the fundamental things that we're agreeing here today in the report that's in front of us is around actually dividing the city off the new 64 wards into 13 neighbourhoods.
step in that direction. Just as Harry said, can't wait for this to be rolled out across the city in the next few months. So, if we can formally move those recommendations, is that agreed?
Agreed.
Brilliant. Okay, we'll move on to the next items. I think, Dan, you're going to do us a mega presentation on all the transport connectivity reports. So, you're going to take us through about four reports. We'll have your presentation, and then I think for the use of buses and that means rail travel is obviously really, really important, but I came to highlight, as you did, the element of the linking up to the Liverpool Loop line where it was trying to think that is really, you talk about delivering a much better route on along West Harbour Road, which you can't get any better from linking up to Liverpool Loop line as well. And I just think this is an example of where a lot of thought has gone, you know, into making something far better than what it was. So if you want to put that route on there, because it's brilliant.
Absolutely. We want to do a cabinet bike ride. Well done for that. Any other questions or comments at this point? In that case, let's go through the legals. Item B is the delivery of active travel schemes. So can I move the recommendations set out in that report if that's agreed? Then moving on to Liverpool City Region Sustainable Transport Settlement, Highway Maintenance Capital Grant Funding Grant. Again, can I move the recommendations set out in that report if that's agreed?
Agreed.
And then procurement for delivery of highway maintenance works, if I can move the recommendations in that report if that's agreed?
Agreed.
And obviously the clean air plan will be coming on to one of the exempt items. That is the end of the presentations for this afternoon, but I hope everyone agrees how useful that actually is to sort of put it in a bit more pictorial form, just not just talk about it, actually show how these things fit together. So looking forward to future presentations on key topics that will be coming to Cabinet for future meetings. But if we move on to the next set of reports, next we're moving on to financial matters, and Ruth, Report A is the revenue and capital outturn.